Okay, welcome back. This is another Ascension video. I have decided to play with a combination of Storm of Souls, Immortal Heroes, Realms Unraveled, and Dawn of Champions. This is probably just my favorite combination of sets, and I haven't actually done that yet. On the channel, I resisted about as long as I could, and so now we're doing it. So, I'm gonna start out. I went ahead and took Soul Shaper because it banishes. Went ahead and grabbed up the Makana Construct that conveniently went directly into play, and picked up one loyalty for my, reputation, I guess it is, for my champion, Dartha. Now, having a hard time getting that to go away for some reason. Okay, so he got a Mystic and a Snake Shaman. So, my choices here are either pick up my second reputation for Dartha, or maybe put the Workshop Gargoyle to work. Kind of a tough call. I think I actually kind of just like getting my second reputation here. Dartha, to help me banish these militia, I need to get those out of the way. Build up a couple mystics. That way I can get cards like Setra and Eren the Godslayer. I think a lot of this set is built on who can make the best late game. This combination of sets that feels like a good way to win. In these sets, and so that's what I'm wanting to try to do, and that's part of why I think that I really enjoy this combination more than some others, because I just like playing for the long game, and truly the game being based around how powerful of a deck you can build. So then mind, I don't necessarily need a mystic yet, because my Dartha is going to help me create some mystics. So I'm going to pick up my second Makana Construct. Nothing wrong with building a Swarm of Constructs, and he gets off to a very good start with that Setra. So now I have to consider, maybe trying to take some of these heroes away as quickly as possible. I don't think Neophyte Mentor, though, is really the hero that he's probably looking for. I'm going to take a Mystic because I'd really like to buy at least that Snapdragon Witch before he gets to it, if I can't get to Eren the Godslayer. Because if I can get ahead in Honor and Snapdragon Witch draw me some cards, I have the Soul Shaper. And the idea is that it's okay if he kills a couple of the big monsters, as long as I'm able to get some of the more powerful cards, even if he gets the Eren. And then along with that, be able to draw the more powerful cards in a timely fashion. Could take the air support squadron here, but I really do think I need to get this Snapdragon Witch. Hopefully, if I can maintain some level of honor creation, I can draw some cards with it. If not, at least it keeps him from drawing a ton of cards with it. Okay, so he did get to Setra the Eren. He'll be drawing that, or he... Oh no, he just bought the Eren. He just straight up bought it. Okay. Fair enough. So I think I do have one Life Bounder, and I don't think that having a second one would be terrible. So I'm going to go ahead and grab that. And I'm definitely going to switch. Plans was to buy the Neophyte. I was going to say that will help me create the Unite effect if I need it. But in this case, this will also. Because I'm just going to banish some more of my starter cards, and Elder Skeptic goes right along with just the general plan of, I really want to be drawing through my deck, hitting my best cards. He has a slight advantage in having the Setra and the Eren, that he really has the two best heroes so far, but I'm going to anticipate that since I'm starting to create some runes and banishing all my starters, that I'll be able to pick up a couple of the better cards as the game goes along too. I just can't turn down a second Elder Skeptic. That just seems to build exactly what I'm wanting to do, and the Nokan to go with it too. Basically, just sort of trying to set up here, trying to build kind of a combo in a sense. And Tower's car would go along with that well also. So the first time around, Snapdragon Witch does get to draw two cards, which is fantastic. I'm going to use this Deathsworn Warrior, and I'm going to go ahead and banish it right away. Just cut out some more of those starting cards. I'm going to get to unite the Wolf Acolyte. I want to get that Tower Ascara in the deck, but I kind of want to get the Starlight Sanctum. It may be more important, but it doesn't look like I'm going to get that this turn, and also I'm not going to get to put the Tower Ascara in before I shuffle. So, definitely not going to be able to get the Starlight Sanctum this turn. So, just going to go ahead and banish this other apprentice. Pick up the Tower Ascara. And, like I said, we're kind of just hoping. I'm going to go ahead and get rid of this apprentice. All right, so I'm almost out of starting cards already, which is a very good start. I need to clear some monsters and find a way to pick up a couple of heroes that are going to help me, to help me finish off this game. Starlight Sanctum is certainly a card that can build an advantage that way, as long as the board isn't just clogged up with monsters the whole way. Would be nice to just have like one card or two cards that could really help me beat monsters, or at least just banish them. Banishing them would be fine. Okay, Skeptic's fine. Very nice. Okay, so definitely gonna have looks like I should have the eight this turn, if that's what I decide on doing. I can. Well, at least I should. I need to actually have another Mystic. Let's see. Second, well, Skeptic, I guess. Yeah, we're gonna discard that. I'm gonna banish the Soul Shaper. I don't think I. Oh wait, I can actually banish a card in my discard pile, and I think that's actually worth the gamble here. So I'm gonna banish this Darthe for a Mystic. And now I have the Starlight Sanctum. Gonna draw a card, play the Starlight Sanctum, and it looks like the best I can do is add a heavy infantry, and then guess I might as well just go ahead and do that. Didn't affect the game in the least. So now he's gonna kill a monster with Aaron. Guess he hasn't yet set up the Nemesis play, and I'm gonna hope to maybe get rid of that card at some point before he does set up the. I think it's probably about time to just go ahead and banish the Soul Shaper. There's nothing really left for me to have to banish. The Avatar Golem comes at a good time. It gains me 2 honor, gets me ahead again, so that this card draws 2 cards. I don't have any void cards for the Initiate's Gauntlets. I think though that what I want to do here is use the Fettered Soul. I'm basically just gonna try to create a more, and I don't want him killing my construct, so a more open board. And there we go. So take the Journeyman Outrider and the Rally, and I now have a bunch of Guide of Lost Souls. I'm not sure. I guess I kind of want another one because I can use those to turn on the Initiate's Gauntlets. And the Cannon Templar is going to be real nice because now that beats just about any monster. So I'm not a huge fan of having 3 Guide of Lost Souls, though. But maybe I can find a way to banish those. I think I will. Well, I'm not going to be able. I could shuffle in the Spider Witch. Yeah, that would be alright. So then I'm going to use Wolf Acolyte, draw a card. Sometimes it's just figuring out how to navigate these sort of tricky turns that helps, that's part of figuring out, how to win with this strategy of banishing and drawing through the deck, because it doesn't do much good to draw all the way through the deck if you're not doing anything. And now we're really starting to come along. I'm gonna take one more heavy. I have a lot of card draw, and I do want to beat some monsters. So I think it's looking pretty good right now, really. Now he's resorted to just having to buy heavies. I said the advantage he has is like the Setra and the Aaron, but he didn't really have a good way to banish. So he's just not gonna draw those as often as I'm gonna draw the cards that I wanna draw, which is exactly the plan, as discussed. So okay. So I'm gonna use a Guide of Lost Souls to banish the other Guide of Lost Souls so that I can beat the Minotaur. Then I'm gonna draw a card because I'm gonna Cannon Templar that Nemesis. It's not about getting max value out of it, it's just about getting something out of it, and I want to clear the center row a little bit. I don't really think I need the heavy right now. Yeah, that's that, and that's exactly why. I have a lot of mystics, so I'll name that with the Great Omen Raven. Time to draw some more cards with Tower Ascara. I'm gonna apologize in advance. I think I can do better at actually describing the strategy of what's going on in this game, if I take some more time to do it. But I'm kind of in trying to hurry a little bit, mainly because I'm afraid if I don't, my opponent is gonna get bored, so to speak, and just go play another game. So I'm gonna beat the Nemesis. Gives me the Minotaur back. I have no more trophies to get here. I'll take a chance and draw a card. I think that'll let me draw through. Maybe I can hit and flip my construct. I would need one more Void Hero. There it is. Okay, very good. So I get to flip my construct, and that opens up the center row a little bit. And in fact, I can beat two monsters here if I need to. So first, the Neophyte is a fine option. I don't think I want the free hero there. Still haven't found one that I really want. And then I think I will go ahead and defeat the Cackling Jackal. Okay, so that was a pretty good turn. Definitely taken a pretty significant lead. Like I said, just basically doing exactly what we set out to do. And it's getting the Soul Shaper on turn one. And then go back and think about, the spark bug hasn't triggered much. I just bought it, kind of clearing the way, looking for other stuff. The Snapdragon Witch paid off a lot. I got that about the same time that he got the Setra, maybe just after. And he has conceded the game. So yeah, that was, and like I said, we were just sort of starting to run away with it. We could draw through here a little bit and kind of take a look, but you can definitely, once you get all the bad cards, so to speak, banished to start with, it's pretty easy to draw through the deck, get exactly what you want, and just go nuts on them turn after turn. So I completely understand. He didn't at all want to continue to watch me kind of play solitaire over here, which is what it sort of turns into after a little while. Activate a cannon. Doesn't really matter. So just gonna discard it. Just finish it another turn, just because, just kind of for the heck of it. It was gonna be the last turn that I was gonna get to take anyway, because I was gonna Cannon Templar that thing, and we'll just claim victory here. So kind of an idea, a general idea of how that combination of sets goes. I hope you enjoyed it. Please feel free to comment. Things that you noticed, anything that maybe I can improve about, just kind of how I'm discussing this, because I've actually played this combination of sets several times, and kind of have a feel for how it goes. And sometimes it's hard to put into words exactly what the plan is when, once you've done a certain thing so many times. So if you have any questions about just kind of what I'm thinking about different choices that I made during the game, I'm certainly interested to talk through some of those things. Thanks again for watching, and see you next time.